Right. Now, in my line of duty, more often than not, people come to me and ask me, "Has which phone do you recommend?" And today, I'm going to be telling you about a phone I don't think will make it on that suggestion list. Before we start, make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn on that bell, give this video a like, and without further ado, cue intro. Now, let's kick this off with an unboxing. Vivo are giving us a clean, simple looking white box. Turning the box, we get to see some of the key features of the phone, and those include an AI triple camera, a 5000 mAh battery, and a 6.35 inch screen, which Vivo are calling the Halo Full View display. And the color I have here is the aqua blue. You can also pick it up in burgundy red. Now, taking the seal apart and opening the box, we are greeted with another box that holds the paperwork and documentation, things people don't read, and a soft silicone case for a bit of added protection. Next, we get the phone. Taking its wrap off reveals the aqua blue color that gives off this shining, pulsant kind of effect when light hits the plastic back. Then we get the SIM ejector tool, a standard power brick, so nothing special going on there, and a charging cable, a micro USB charging cable. That kind of sucks, since this late in 2019, you kind of expect Vivo to ship you a phone with USB Type-C, but okay, we take what we get. And that's all you get in the box, no headphones included. Now, let's go check out the phone itself. Starting with the design of the phone, you get your volume rocker and power button on the right side of the phone. Turning the phone down, you see the speaker grille, micro USB port, microphone, and headphone jack. On the plastic back lies the fingerprint scanner, nothing on the top, the SIM slot on the top right part, the 16 megapixel front facing camera up front, and finally, the triple camera setup at the back. First impressions, I'd say the phone feels quite hefty in your hands, and you'll probably notice if it wasn't in your pocket thanks to that heavy, massive 5000 mAh battery. And as culture is these days, the glossy back on this phone is a fingerprint magnet, and I suggest you slap the silicone case it came with. It kind of adds more weight to the already heavy phone and takes the aesthetic from it, but those fingerprints look ugly and dirty on the phone. Jumping into the phone's internals, the Vivo Y15 is running on Android 9 Pie straight out of the box, with Vivo's FunTouch OS running on top of Android. All that is backed up by 4 GB of RAM and 64 gigs of internal storage. And sad news, there is no other variant. Would have been kind of nice to see a 128 gig model with 6 gigs of RAM, but then again, hey, we take what we get. On to the display. Now, as earlier mentioned, Vivo are calling this 6.35 inch screen the Halo Full View display, and it's a 720 by 1544 resolution screen, bringing out 81.4% screen to body ratio. The display is quite bright, so you don't need to worry about using it outdoors, but then again, it does have quite noticeable bezels, with this teardrop notch at the top housing the front-facing camera and one really massive chin. The phone does come with a traditional fingerprint scanner that unlocks the phone pretty fast every time, and I personally like where it has been placed, making it easy to reach even without looking for it. The phone also has face unlock, which I must say is pretty fast, works well each time, and is somehow hard to cheat with photos or even lookalikes. Props to Vivo for having that unlock. As always, we can't do a review without the speaker test. So here is what the Vivo Y15 sounds like. I don't have much to complain or compliment. The sound is clear and balanced. I kind of wish it was a bit louder and had more punch to it in terms of bass, but it's not too terrible. Also, worth mentioning, the phone does have a mono bottom firing speaker, meaning no sound comes out of the earpiece to give you that stereo sound experience. But then again, at this price point, stereo speakers will come as a surprise. Now, here is where my love-hate relationship with this phone tipped over more to the hate part. First up, FunTouch feels kind of cluttered, overly cluttered. Cluttered in the way the settings app is arranged. See, navigating through settings trying to find that specific setting can be quite a task since the main options aren't placed where they normally will be found in majority of other devices. Example, to find the About Phone options, in almost all phones you just have to swipe and it'll surely be among the last options in the settings app. But here, you have to go through other settings first before you can find it. Such an arrangement makes you feel like Vivo was trying too hard to be different and stand out at the cost of making you feel like you don't know what you're doing. That, my friends, is one frustrating feeling. Such frustrations also spill over to easy tasks like turning on the 100 mode, where Vivo wants you to quickly swipe left and right, other than normally swipe on the navigation buttons or the diagonal swipe up. See how it seems like they were trying a bit too hard to be different and stand out? Next misfire is on the cameras. Now, you get a 13 megapixel f2.2 primary shooter, backed up by an 8 megapixel f2.2 ultra-wide angle lens, and a 2 megapixel f2.4 depth sensor, which make the phone look very good and well equipped on paper, but it has nothing to show for those numbers. The standard lens does do an okay job, but clarity is lost when the ultra-wide angle takes over. It does take hazy images that just won't cut it. The presence of the depth sensor also doesn't make sense since there is no dedicated portrait mode in the camera app, meaning you have to edit the blur background in the gallery after you've taken the photo, same as you will before posting a picture on Instagram. Videos also max out at 1080p, but will also leave you wishing they were better. The phone does try to better the image quality after the shots, but they still aren't shots you'd be proud of. In fact, other cheaper competitors like the Samsung A30 do a better job than this. I like the fact that you can use the fingerprint scanner as the shutter button when taking selfies, but then again, selfies here are just straight up hot garbage. Now, you get a 16 megapixel f2.2 front-facing camera, and that will be enough to get your hopes up. And it does, but soon after, the photos taken just fail you. The selfie camera launches in beauty mode by default, and can I just mention, the beauty mode shots on here are just terrible. It's as if the whole image processing process was just a huge guess, as seen by the softened patches on my face in these sample shots. Normal selfies might seem a little bit palatable, certainly better than the beauty shots, but they still don't make the cut. There are also gimmicks in the camera, like the panorama mode in the selfie camera, which I understand is an effort to try and make up for the lack of a wide-angle selfie lens. But sadly, it is also a hit or miss. Nothing guaranteed. Which makes my point even clearer. Vivo was just trying too hard on this one. I mean, there are phones out there with one selfie camera that just add a crop into the picture to give it a sense of wider selfies, and they do a pretty good job at it. But this here is just another failed attempt at standing out. Also, viewing content on here won't be that clear as you might expect. You might blame it on the lower resolution 720p screen, but then again, Vivo didn't have an excuse not to fit a 1080p screen on here. I mean, they did fit a large enough battery to power a higher resolution, right? Even at max resolution, video quality still doesn't look that good. In terms of gaming, the phone does try to deliver smooth frame rates, but you will notice that periodic stutter when gaming. All in all, games are pretty much responsive, and that 4GB of RAM coupled with that MediaTek processor helps keep the game open in the background a little bit longer. You also get this Ultra Game Mode utility that kind of stores all your games in one place and is said to give you that extra juice to smoothen your gaming experience, but at this point, one can't quite see or feel its effect. You can't know if it's on or off because there's literally no difference. Maybe just blocking your notifications as you game. You also get this gimmick reverse wired charging via an OTG, where the 5000 mAh battery allows you to share the charge with another device. But let me just ask, out of the billions and billions of people on the planet, who walks around with an OTG for the purpose of sharing charge? There's just a lot of things in that sentence that don't sit right with me. Now, starting from the fact that if that was such an important feature of the phone, why wasn't an OTG bundled in the box? Also, just the whole contraption from the micro USB OTG to a normal USB cable to either a USB Type-C or micro USB is just too bulky of a setup and sounds way, way inconvenient. Might as well have put reverse charging on the phone or leave the reverse wired charging part out of it. Well, now you see my love-hate relationship with the Vivo Y15 and why it's a bit hard to say who this phone is for. Apart from a massive battery fitted on there, there's not much going for the phone. Maybe with future software updates, the phone might get better, but at this point in time, going on that piece of hope just doesn't feel safe. Well, that's it from me. If you want to go pick this phone up, it's going to send you back 20,000 shillings. My name is Hezion. This is Lord Hezion. Hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful. If you did, a thumbs up would be appreciated. Be that cool girl or guy that shares this video. Subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any future uploads. And let me see you in the next one.